Hey, hey, what's up, Muriel from the Sunshine Family and living in Costa Rica. As an expat, if you're thinking about moving to Costa Rica, these are the things that I would do completely different if I could redo moving to Costa Rica. So if you're curious about what I have to share, watch my video to the end. But before I'm gonna dive in, I would want you to consider to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet. That might help you to learn more about all my mistakes, all the things I've learned as an expat mom living here in Costa Rica. I moved in 2018 with my husband Dirk and two growing up kids. I've learned so much, and my channel is dedicated to share everything that I have learned along my way that can help you prevent lots of disasters and just provide you up, you know, daily information from a mom from Europe who lives in Costa Rica really happily. So yeah, you can subscribe to my channel by hitting that little square icon you see around my video with Dirk and my face on it. Hit the bell icon to get a notification every time I upload a new video. But with that being said, let's just dive in. This is funny. I interviewed my husband Dirk and asked him, love, what would you do differently when moving to Costa Rica right now? So looking back on living in Costa Rica for 2.5 years already, and I'm super proud of it. Funny enough, we both said the same things. The top number one is what he mentioned right away. It was my top number two. But it was getting started in a different rental house when after the move, so to say. So let me tell you a quick story about how we got to our first rental house here in Costa Rica. So we were first vacationing in Costa Rica. It was like a checkout vacation to see where we would plant our flag, so to say. I also shared it in my my ebook, which you can order if you would like and interested in 7 steps to moving to Costa Rica. 7 steps to move to Costa Rica. I share there that a checkout vacation is handy, so you see, you know, which location fits you best for your family needs, for yourself, whatever, what you prefer: mountains, ocean, Pacific side, the other side. Just that. So we started with a rental house from a lady we met during that vacation. She was well known for renting out other people's places. So we trusted her. She showed us a couple of houses, but at the end, nothing was really the right fit for us. But she ended up looking for someone to rent her own house, which we actually immediately agreed on because we liked her and we trusted her, but didn't really end up the way that we wanted to. Unless we knew that the house wasn't that big, there were some things that were not cool. We found out that she was asking way too much rent compared to what it was worth it, compared to the stuff she still had left in her house. And basically, now living in Costa Rica for 2.5 years, I would do it differently. I would do this differently. When still living in my own country, I would join several Costa Rican community groups, you know, or during my vacation. I would just, before I move in any ways, but get started being active member in Facebook Costa Rica related community groups, especially close to the area you prefer. And perfect would be while you are there on a checkout vacation, and just ask in that group for a rental house with all your specific needs, and then see who is messaging you. The best for doing that while you're on vacation in Costa Rica, to check out what is all there, so when you go back to your country to really make the move happen, sell your stuff and prepare for the big leap, you have something to get back to on the context you already created during your checkout vacation. We basically leaned only on her, and only at the end of that checkout vacation we found out that there was a community group in the area where we live now. Thanks to that community group, after our move to Costa Rica, we found an incredible cool house for a very decent price where we lived for 8 months after leaving this crappy house where we paid way too much. So ask the help of the community, especially while you're there, because I'm not a fan of making agreements based on the house that you have never visited, because you never know how it looks like for real. But yeah, that is definitely what I would differently, and Dirk agreed on it. So finding a better house was definitely possible, but you know, it wasn't that bad. After 2 months, we found our awesome rental house, and after that, another rental house, and we stayed there until we were able to move to our own property. So number two, what I would do totally differently, if I knew what I know now after living in Costa Rica as an expat for 2.5 years, I would definitely start actively learning Spanish from day zero. I would start Duolingo, just on the app, the free app, on my smartphone before I would move. To be really, really transparent with you, my Spanish is still crappy. I'm transparent, I'm honest, I'm not proud of it, and I do my best at the bank and every corner, or shop, whatever. I start in Spanish, but it's hard for me to really do a fluid conversation. I really thought and wished and dreamed about that while living in a country, the language would be like an immediate automatic process, but I think that's more for kids. Unfortunately, it didn't happen with me. Yes, I do understand a lot, but having a conversation and keeping the conversation going is still really hard. And I'm honest, I didn't put effort in it. So since a couple of days, I started actively with Duolingo, and that helps you really to have conversations. And come on, let's be real. If you live in Costa Rica, the language is so important, because not just for yourself, but also out of respect for people who live here, it's really easier when you can express yourself, when you are able to have a conversation. It's not only just better if you that you adjust to the culture and the language in your country, it's also easier for yourself and for the others, so you can make yourself understandable in shops where still a lot of Costa Rican people do not speak English. It's a fact. So I hope that my short video today is helpful, so you can learn from my mistakes. And yeah, that is it for today. It is a short video, but I think that's fine too. Let me know if you're watching, if you are living in Costa Rica as an expat, what things you would do differently. I'm actually really curious, because my story is not yours, and vice versa. Also, just to help out my viewers on the channel, I'm really looking forward to hearing from you. And I always, somewhere in my video, I say something like, hey, PS, are you curious what I do to make my living in Costa Rica? I still wanted to add this, because I think it's important to know that, and I shared it in all my other videos, in some of my other videos, earning an income in Costa Rica, the possibilities have changed with the changes in the world right now, with COVID. I already made my living online as affiliate marketer, an online coach. You can read more in the description under my video. Click the first link to learn more. But I also have my own coaching program for many, many years. I really updated it recently based on the needs and wants and questions that people ask me. So just check out the description below my video. I think the best you can do is to build a roof while the sun is still shining, so to say. So if you're not in Costa Rica yet to live here, start learning how you can generate an income online. It's what I'm so grateful for, that I can fall back on, that I don't have a job, I don't have a brick and mortar business, and I want it for you as well. So don't be hesitant to learn more about it. Better check out one of my links below my video. But now I'm really going to end my video. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for my next videos. Expect one tomorrow. And if you have any questions, let me know. As always, I'm happy to help, and also here to reply to your replies. Give me your thumbs up if you think I deserve it. Share your video with someone you think can need it, can use it. And yeah, subscribe to the channel if you want to. So bye from Costa Rica.